where it's not that easy to get people together. We made the decision to go unmiked today here, so you'll have to continue to let us know if you can hear us or not. I'm sort of going to walk you through a little bit of the roots of the orchestra, and to let you know that, for those of you who don't know, the orchestra goes back to a North Shore resident, West Vancouver resident, Hillary Clark, a flautist, who canvassed French hornist Anita Sleeman, and who was also a composer and conductor, to conduct a small group of friends, amateur musicians, on a Wednesday afternoon, and there were informal rehearsals in West Vancouver, hence the name Ambleside Orchestra. But I don't want to share too much of that because we're extremely honored and pleased to have Hillary here today, and she is going to take us down memory lane, the beginnings of Ambleside Orchestra.
I sometimes feel I'm undressing when I do this. If I fall over, would somebody please pick me up and put me back on the podium? Anyway, I'm Hillary Clark, and I have a question for you. How many of you have had a dream of something you wanted to do and then actually done it? Put your hands up. Very good, very good. The Ambleside Orchestra was my dream. When I retired from Capilano College / University, / that sounds terrible, doesn't it? Anyway, I wanted an orchestra to play in because I was an amateur musician. And when I say amateur, I would go to my level of mediocrity on one instrument and then take up another instrument. And that went on for a while, and I thought, well, I want something to I want to play in the daytime. I want to play in my hometown. Okay, I'll start an orchestra. So I sent this around the faculty at Cap, and the head of the music department, I don't know whether any of you remember Carl Koblansky, great guy, lovely conductor. Good. And he said, oh, Hillary, forget it. I tried it. It can't be done. I said, Carl, watch me. And I went to the senior center in West Van, and I said, I'd like to start an orchestra. Oh, they said, yes, we've got bands in here. How many people are you thinking of? 10, maybe 5? I said, try 30. She said, 30? Where are we going to put 30? So I said, just let me do it. I have one request. I'm entirely in charge. Everything I say is going to take place, and that doesn't work, we're out of here. So at that point, they sort of got aghast at this insolence from this, that's 30 years ago, I was younger and brighter. And away I went. So I gathered together all of the amateur musicians I knew. Well, guess how many? We had 11 people the first time, 7 wind instruments and 1 violin. I thought, well, 1 violin is not going to go very far with the symphony orchestra, which I had in mind. But we started, and we had Dr. Anita Sleeman. Well, she was a member of the music department, doctorate in music, recognized Canadian composer, general genius. So I went to her and I said, Anita, I'm starting an orchestra. Would you consider conducting it? Expecting no. With those credentials, who's going to do an amateur orchestra of 10 people in a senior center? Go figure. So Anita said, yes. I said, yes? You're going to do this? Of course I'm going to do it. She said, do you know how difficult it is for a woman to get an orchestra to conduct? She said, go try sometime. So we started off, and Anita charged in. She was fabulous. She wrote music for us. She brought people in. She was humorous. She was very, very loving and caring. Just a real sweet, sweet person. And she put up with us sort of seniors, sort of. Because, well, that's what I said at the senior center. You can't limit me. You can't tell me it only has to be seniors because I want open. Okay. I said, I also have to be open in terms of instrumentation. Okay. Well, after about 2 years, a guy turned up with a clarinet. Well, we already had four clarinets. Most symphony orchestras only need two, maybe a third if it's pressed. So he said, I want to join. I said, no, we've got enough clarinets. I said, if you'd like to take up the bassoon, we could use a bassoon. He said, I'm not taking up the bassoon. I said, sorry. So he went to the administration of the senior center and complained. So I was called on the mat. And I said, what the hell do you think you're doing? I said, we had a deal. I was entirely in charge, entirely in control, musicians, instrumentation, everything. They said, well, this is our mandate at this building. This is the senior center. They have to be able to. I said, okay, we're leaving. She said, what do you mean you're leaving? I said, well, this isn't the only room in West Vancouver. So I searched around, and not only did we find Highlands, bless their hearts, we also found that we had better get ourselves incorporated. So I said, this, we're now out of the senior center. That was 5 years at the senior center. We are now in charge. We are having a board of directors. We are incorporating. We are becoming a nonprofit. We're going to request loans and budgets and money from wonderful people. And we sort of kissed the senior center goodbye. Bless their hearts, they did a good job at the beginning. And here we are. So the Ambleside Orchestra is my dream. I played in it for many years. I love it dearly. And the idea of mine was of a community orchestra that anybody could come and play in, as long as we needed the instrumentation. That was the bottom line. You can't turn up with a ukulele or a harmonica, thanks very much. We've got to be in charge of the instrumentation. And with Anita, who was in charge, big time, we had our instrumentation. So you're now here, I believe this is the 30th, was actually the 30th in the fall. And I'm 92. And I started this when I was, do the math, when I was 62 and played until a couple of years ago. And then COVID came in and all that nonsense. So you are going to love this orchestra as I love it. And thank you so much for being here and supporting us. It's been fun.
That was an inspiring story, Hillary.
Was it 10 minutes?
We weren't counting. You could have kept on going, frankly. I just love the grit and the scrappy nature of the initiative, and to really believe it and to take it on, as you know, in those days and the roles that you were in. And we are so grateful to be part of this orchestra. We thank you so much. It's a joy for us on Wednesdays to be together. And so thank you very much. So Hillary's giving you some perspective, some color of what the start of the orchestra was, and I'm just going to add a little bit now with respect to what does a Wednesday look like and what do rehearsals look like. They're here, as Hillary says, now 25 years in Highlands, and this administration here is absolutely wonderful to work with. Like today, there were a lot of logistical issues that arose, and they jumped to attention to help us achieve this concert, and as we all know, we had to reschedule because of the December 18th catastrophic weather event, and we as a board feel that we made the right decision to not call on people to go outside on that day and take risks. So here we are, finally. This is a third time lucky, which I guess is a bit precious that it's our 30th anniversary, or 30th and a half year anniversary. So one of the things that we do is once a year, we gather in October, and we jump on a bus, bus comes outside, and the bus takes us down to the Carnegie Center in the downtown east side. And it is truly the orchestra's favorite concert, not to mean any disrespect, but being in the downtown east side and playing for people who have otherwise not had an opportunity to see a classical performance is truly remarkable. People will conduct along as they're listening to the music. Some of them will leave their chairs and they'll run and they'll go outside and they'll bring a group of friends in to hear the music. And this year, you know, it was a super intense experience, I would say, because during COVID, obviously, there's been a tremendous impact on the downtown east side, and it was very evident driving through there at 7 o'clock at night what the hardship is for these people. So it's something that we love to do. As most of you know, the main stage concerts are typically here at Highlands, and we have they're relatively sophisticated concerts. We're getting more and more sophisticated. We have incredibly accomplished soloists that have joined us. Jean Ramsbottom, who is named a distinguished artist by Funding for the Arts in North Shore in 2015. Bass singer Andrew Stewart, mezzo-soprano Hilary Crowther, bassoonist Isaac Bell, and Don Clark, who is in our horn section, who has enjoyed a long career as one of Canada's leading trumpet and flugelhorn players. He's performed with the likes of Ella Fitzgerald and Nat King Cole and the New Orleans Connection, just to name a bit of his accomplishments. Today, of course, we have saxophonist Julia Nolan. She's performed with the Vancouver Symphony Orchestra, Vancouver New Music Society, Vancouver Opera Orchestra, and the CBC Jazz Orchestra, and you will enjoy her performance immensely. Members of the orchestra periodically perform chamber music concerts, and some of those of you who are on our subscription MailChimp would have received a poster for that. These chamber events repertoire is presented in the Silk Purse Gallery, North Vancouver's St. Agnes Anglican Church, and features wind quintets, brass quintets, quintets, string trios, piano, horn duets, etc. So our next concert is on January 20th at St. Agnes Anglican Church on 12th Street. Off Grand Boulevard. Our growth in musicality is a direct result of the leadership of world-class conductor Maestro Bouillard Lapadite. You'll meet him shortly. He received his formal training at the Academy of Arts in Tirana, Albania, and the Conservatoire National in France before coming to Canada. Bouillard was the artistic director of the Albanian National Theatre of Opera and Ballet. Performing today with us is the Lionsgate Brass, which is comprised of members of the orchestra, and the West Vancouver Youth String Band Strings, under the direction of Nicholas Urquhart. We're excited to share that Nicholas's direction, we will be launching a spring program in the coming months, and the purpose is to encourage people who have played string instruments in the past, parked them for a while, and would like to revitalize those skills. And so we'll be broadcasting that through all of our communication and marketing materials that we send out to you and through other forums. And so if anybody in the orchestra has a string instrument that they would like to dust off, please stay tuned. It's interesting how much response we've had to this as soon as we started talking about it and pushing it out. So now, most importantly, we are forever grateful for you, our patrons, for providing us with an audience and providing us with your generous donations to help the orchestra evolve its ambitious goals. We're grateful to have had many contributors over the past years. For this particular concert, I'd like to particularly a big shout out to our live streaming service, Audio Sprout, to Deanna Embry, who is a good friend and helped with catering today, and to Ellen and Yelm Deman for sponsoring the concert master chair for the next repertoire, and to Walter Wisota Management, who's provided financial support to the orchestra for quite some time now. So to all those people, we're extremely grateful. And with that, I'd like to introduce to you Maestro Bouillard Lapage.
Thank you, thank you. Let's do music now.
Thank you.
Now it's time for Nick to conduct this orchestra.
Good evening, or good afternoon. Just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Nicholas Urquhart, and I've recently been appointed director of strings and associate conductor with this orchestra, and I'm very proud to be part of this orchestra now, and I want to formally thank you for that appointment. It's an honor to be working with you. So thank you very much. I'll be conducting two pieces, and we have a partnership with my youth orchestra, the WVYB Symphonic Strings, that we'll see a little bit later on in the program. This piece is the Karelia Suite by John Sibelius. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening. Good evening. To the music, to the scores. Thank you for playing the piano. Thank you. Well.
Thank you. So we are the Lionsgate Brass, so-called because when we formed about 3 years ago, three of us are from the North Shore, two are from Vancouver. When we rehearsed or performed, one group of us always would have to cross the Lionsgate Bridge. And Lionsgate Brass was, I guess, it was Tom's idea.
It was
Tom's fault. And a great fault it was. We're going to perform today a piece by the Philip Jones Brass Ensemble, and it's originally published in the year 2000 for a 10-piece group, so a double quintet, so double what we have. And it was arranged, it's been arranged for every type of group from quintet to brass band. So Chris, he lives in a really small English village, and he wrote a cat suite that was really popular, so popular that he wrote another cat, Kraken. But in his words, here's what he says about this. Some years ago, I had four cats in the house. All were strays and decided that I was a soft touch when it came to free board and lodgings. So instead of moving on, they all decided to stay. Sadly, they have all now gone to the great cattery in the sky. However, at the time they were around, I was asked to write some pieces for a brass group, Philip Jones Brass Ensemble. They're like our Canadian brass, but they're about a decade older than our Canadian brass. So they've been around a while. What should I write about? Well, I've always liked writing about the people and places around me. They appear in a lot of my music. So I thought, I know my cats. So Chris wrote these first three movements called Three Brass Cats, which featured three male cats, Mr. Jums, Black Sam, and Borge. Where he lived, there were a lot of Borge plants around his village. I don't know, I guess Black Sam was black, and I don't know where he got the name Mr. Jums. However, Kraken is the only female cat of the quartets, and it ruled the clouder. Clouder. Only half the size of the other. So clouder, by the way, anybody know what a clouder is? Oh good, there's a few. For those that don't, other than the two that do, a clouder of, I guess they're kind of like domestic house cats, would be like, you know, a herd of cows, a flock of geese, a murder of crows, a parliament of owls, a pride of lions, a clouder of cats, so that's the term for it. Kraken, it must be a pretty ferocious cat because in Greek mythology, Kraken is really a monster that can take down ships with giant tentacles and destroy cities, all that sort of thing. So, since we are Lionsgate Brass, it is with our pride that we perform in the cat theme for you this afternoon. But first, you got to know a little bit about this piece because it makes more sense when you know what the heck the music sounds like in pictures. So, Kraken, remember, pretty ferocious, rules of the male cats, etc. You can sort of hear, when you hear these, we call them brass shots, these are loud, crisp shots of music. So you know when a cat gets cornered or is ready to, like Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, ready to strike, it gets that kind of an ow sound. Well, that's a brass shot. So you hear a number of these, including right at the end when the cat is really stealth. You think everything is safe, and then it strikes on the last note of the piece. Also, there's a soft side to Kraken. You'll hear the cat purring in the middle, and I'm playing second trumpet for this, and I get to play the purring part. And it's very soft, it's a beautiful melody. Cats are very smart. You can train cats just like dogs. Most people don't have to or don't want to. Cats are very smart, so it'll also do a fugue. So you hear a fugue, which, you know, hard to write a fugue and make it make sense. And I guess that's about all we're going to say about Kraken, except for play it, of course. Thank you. tune. Second trumpet is much different from first trumpet. There we go.
Take two.
Now we're warmed up.
Yeah. Thank you.
I just wanted to introduce the group before you. This is the WVYB Symphonic Strings. It's part of the WVYB, which stands for West Van Youth Band, the longest standing band in BC, I believe. So it was formed about the year you were born, from my calculations. The year before you were born. So it's 1 year older than you. And about 11 years ago, the organization added a string ensemble. And I've been part of that string ensemble for most of that time. And it's a group that meets on Saturday mornings, bright and early. These guys, well, bright and early for teenagers, it's 10:30. And so most of these students don't know each other until they enter that room, and they form great friendships through music. And we perform about 7 concerts in the community through the year. We're going to perform 2 pieces for you today. The first one is by John Rutter, a living composer, his Dashing Away from his string serenade, and as well 2 cultural variations, we're calling them. Tchaikovsky wrote Swan Lake, and in that Swan Lake there is a couple of different features. One is a Hungarian feature and the other was an Italian feature. So you hear those 2 quick encores right after the John Rutter. Please enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
you, thank you. Now the last piece of the program. But beautiful one.
Thank you.
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I really love it. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for coming. And wait you in the March concert. It will be a surprise. Yeah. Yeah, sure. We have some good surprises there. Unusual for this concert, classical. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. A happy 30th anniversary. Thank you. Hey, was good.
Amazing what an extra 2 months will do for you.
Great to work.
Fine. How are we doing?
Now we burn this. Now we can burn it. Oh, no, we're doing the rest of it.
We start with the first, second, and third.
Good. Okay, good. Thanks.
Yeah, yes. We have to do all these. We have some things.
Are we setting anything new on?
Maybe I do.
Am I
setting? Who's that concert?
Oh, that'd be. Who's? Which one?
Okay.
Oh, which one? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not playing. Yeah,
nice.
So, who's that? Just do violin, piano, do a boy, clarinet. That's what I'm saying. I talked to him.
Yeah,
okay. Recorded for posterity.